And we are still discussing on the issue surviving the current crisis as a migrant. So our guest today is no other person but our own person, Miss Amaka, a politician with the Partei van de A. I think you love your party so much.
Yes, yes.
You are the cheerleader, is that?
The vice chairlady
yeah. Of Partei
van de Arbeid, the Labour Party. Being a social democrat, I think.
Yeah. It's P van de A. That's what I know. Yeah. Okay. Now, can you tell us in the budget of 2012, which items are the most likely to affect us all, especially the migrant community, and how are we supposed to respond to them?
First, I'll start by saying that when the budget, because it's the wethouder makes the budget with the ambtenaren of his ambtenaren, and they will bring it to us as councillors, and we approve it or we won't approve it. Make motions on it or amend it by new proposals because maybe we're not satisfied with the way things stand up. And when the budget came, we of the PEI van de A, we called the Labour Party for. We thought that the things in it to make it easier for job participation was lacking.
Okay.
So most of our proposals or amendments on the budget was for job participation. Yeah, that's what we did. Another thing is we are cutting budgets, like we said. We in Southeast have to cut our budget by 16.3 million,
wow.
Which is no joke. That means all of us, we are going to fail it.
Yes.
So there will be a lot of emphasizes on the normal citizen to do more volunteer work, because you have to help the government, because the government is now cutting budget. That means that all the things people used to do that were involved, money was involved, all of those things will not be available anymore. Especially organizations,
wow.
A lot of organizations are going to fail it. And like we migrants, we have all of the migrants have their own code of organizations that ask subsidy,
yes,
to do work, to
yes.
Help empower their people and
yes.
All of those things.
Yes.
And we cutting budget means that a lot of organizations who are going to ask subsidy may be declined, may not get it.
Yes.
So those are the big problems I think migrants people will be facing, because that means that migrant organizations have to work together right now. Means that most of the time the problems that
how do you mean that they must work together when they have different policies or different visions they are pursuing?
Yeah. That's what I'm coming to explain right now. When we come to poverty, we come to jobless people, it's no different for a Nigerian or for a Ghanaian or for a Suriname. When you are poor, you are poor.
Yes.
When you are out of job, you are out of job.
It's true.
Being a Ghanaian, be a Suriname, be a Nigerian, there is no difference.
Yes, exactly.
So, exactly. That's why they have to merge and come together. And when you come together, you are talking. We are talking about synergy. it's cheaper, and so if three or four organizations come together and they do one big project to help, maybe let me say 100 or 1,000 migrants, it's cheaper and it's also easier for them to get subsidy to do that than right now saying that the Nigerians are only taking care of the Nigerians, the Ghanaians are only the Sudanese are taking only care of the Sudanese.
Yeah, yeah.
It's
okay.
It's not going to work like that anymore.
Okay.
So those are the new policies because of the budget cuts. If you ask subsidy as an organization because you only want to help the Hindustani Surinamese,
yes,
they may decline you because they will ask you to go and search with other organizations who are doing the same thing like you are doing and work together.
Wow, that's going to be a little bit tough.
It is going to be. That means we have to change our mindset and our mentality. And we migrants, we like doing things separate,
which is
not helping. And I think sometimes we can learn from each other. I've seen that through the past years that our problems, we being migrants, our problems are all the same everywhere.
Yes.
When you go to London, when you go to America,
yeah.
migrants' problems are, migration problem is the same everywhere. Yeah.
Yes.
So we have to learn from each other. We have to come together, embrace each other, and try to work together. I think that will help a lot.
So you've told us about cutting a job. Or cutting your budget
mm-hmm.
and matching migrant organizations together. You've told us about that.
Yeah.
So what more? What more are in your items? What more are in your budget?
One of the what we have seen looking around in Amsterdam Southeast, we've seen that all the outsend bureaus are majorly in Amsterdam support. If you go out of Amsterdam support, there are no outsend bureaus.
It's true.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's true.
So it's something that all the years we have accepted it, but if you look at it, very strange. How come that all the outsend bureaus are only in Amsterdam support? There is no outsend bureau in Gansumhof, there is no one in Hollandrecht, which is very, very strange. And especially now knowing Hollandrecht is becoming a problem area neighborhood right now.
Okay.
So what we did is we came with a proposal. We only chose two neighborhoods because it's a pilot.
Okay.
To bring a CV, it's an item bureau, a digital item bureau, that's how I would call it.
Oh, okay.
It's not an item bureau where you can walk in, but we said one at Gansumhof and one at Hollandrecht. Hollandrecht, when people are coming from the metro station,
uh-huh.
you see there is this big red wall,
okay.
the BAM wall,
yeah.
and we can place a digital television or item bureau over there where the jobs will be coming
yes.
all the time. So
if
24 hours a day, if you come late from your job because not everybody has the time to go, and normal item bureaus work from 9 to 5, and
yeah.
most of the time people are working and they
yeah.
can't. So, and we told the Spotify holder to go and talk with item bureaus, potential temporary whatever, potential item bureaus to make sure that the jobs that we want our migrants or whatever to be there
yes.
on the screen. So it will be changing all the time. So people come in, going, doing their groceries, can just go and see there. Is there something? All you have to do is write the number
mm-hmm.
of where to call
yeah.
to see if you can send your CV and if you can get a job.
So you intend that to start up in 2012? Or is it already on?
No, we made that proposal. We just made that proposal in November
2019. I support that. That's a very good one.
Yeah, so it will start in 2012.
So you have one in Hollandrecht and one in Gansumhof?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like a digital item bureau, that's how we call it. So it's changing. It will cost also less because there will not be anybody sitting there. The people will be from Central Point trying to change the jobs and
yes.
everything. So I think those are the little things that we can do to help people in these tough times.
Mm-hmm. Wow. As our own politician, in which compromises in 2012 budget were you able to win for the weak and vulnerable in the society? That's our own. Our own politician. In 2012 budget, were you able to win for the weak and vulnerable in the society? Which areas were you able to fight for us?
Yeah. I think some of the examples I've given, we also asked, like I said, for the job, because there is the whole of Amsterdam, the gemeente Amsterdam,
mm-hmm.
there is a proposal already I've been given for to create jobs, like the money, there is a budget there to help people to create jobs and all those things.
Yeah.
And we asked, because if we look at our population, the people living here,
mm-hmm.
we asked to be the Stadsdeel with the district where the Sorg, that's
yeah.
the care,
yeah.
Like being a nurse, and all the, so that Gemeente Amsterdam has to help us to be the district where this will be possible, so that people can go easily to find that kind of job, the care
okay.
jobs, and mm-hmm. also we call it technician, yeah. Because people like working with their hands over here and all yeah. those things. So yeah. That one already has started in the arena area.
Okay.
A little, so that all the young boys standing out on the corner of the street doing nothing.
Yes.
You can help them because most of them really are really handy. They really know how to use their hands.
Okay.
And they just don't have the diplomas. So
yeah.
you can help
yeah.
them
yeah.
to have a little training so that they can be technicians.
And okay.
Those are some of the things that we are trying to do to help the people. I think I talked about that the job, the transports and
yes,
the logistics.
Yeah,
that there are a lot of jobs.
Yeah,
that we can
yes.
also, we have spoken, we did that ourselves, it was not a proposal that we did that out of ourselves to talk to some of the ISOM bureaus who are specialized in transport and logistics. That people having the ISOM bureau, I think, will help you to fund to pay for your driver-wise D, because
oh,
people
yes.
driving for the big trucks,
yes, exactly.
you need a driving license D.
Yes.
And those are little things that our people here are capable of doing.
Okay.
But you just don't have the driving license, and that driving license D is an expensive one.
Yes, it
so,
is.
So, yeah, but there is these trajects with the ISOM bureaus that you can do it, and when you get a job,
you
pay them back.
Oh, so is it going on already?
It is going on, but... for the one or other reason, those kind of ISOM bureaus are not here.
Where are they?
They're outside Amsterdam Southeast. Some of them are in the Centrum or in Western. So we talked with some of them. So those are some of the ISOM bureaus that we can have on our digital, the jobs that we can have on our digital board.
Yeah.
Because we are not only talking about ISOM bureaus who are concentrated in the Belmer,
yeah.
but we also want to especially recruit the ISOM bureaus that are not here,
yes.
but we know that they have the kind of jobs that our people are capable of doing. So,
okay. Our listeners out there, we still have just one question for Miss Ama before she goes, before we sign off. We encourage you to call us on 020-737-1619 and ask her some of the questions blocking your mind. So, our last question, Ama, how bad are things going to be and how best can we prepare to deal with the harsh times?
Wow.
From yes, from your heart. Speak right now like
wow.
an African child.
I wish I had a glass ball that I could look into the future and things are going to be hard, but I don't think we should give up hope. I always say if you have life you
Hello, good morning.
Yeah, good morning, caller. May we know who you are?
My name is Francis.
All right.
I was really enjoying the program you were doing, but I have a question going to Mr. Ama.
Yes.
Yeah, because I mean, just explaining that there's a bureau they can teach you to get a license fee. So later on, you're going to pay them as well. But can I get a number from them?
Oh, you want to have the bureau that she spoke about? Well, Ama,
yeah.
they want to know whether you can answer.
Yeah. I don't have it with me right here, but I will make sure that Voice of Niger Radio will get it and they can announce it on on the radio. So that's what I will do for you.
To be today, please.
I don't know what time when I get home, if no Voice of Niger will be. I'll make sure that I can email it today to this evening, but I don't think that you will be available.
No.
So you can put it on the website.
Well, you can call us also on 0684606550, and when Ama sends the number, then we can also send it to you, and otherwise we can put it on our website and then people can also go there and take it. That is the Radio Voice of Niger at radiovoiceofniger.org.
Okay.
You're welcome, Francis. Bye. Yes, Ama, can you tell us how bad we must expect this, because we are about to round up now.
Yeah. Like I said, there are hard times coming on our way. But I am a positive person. I always see things from the positive way. I
yes.
think that's how you have to look at life.
Yeah.
And despite all the hardship, if you have God, you have everything. So I think we have our life, we are still alive. Mm-hmm. We are trying to make it the best way we can to survive.
Yeah.
And I think I will encourage the youth also to do their best, stay in school, finish their education.
Yes.
Because if you have your diploma, you have everything, the chances in the future are clear, more better for you. So there are hard times coming, but I don't look at it that way. I would like to look at it from the positive side, and that's what I would advise everybody to do.
Yeah.
Because I think only focusing on the negative side is really bad for your health,
exactly.
Which is not good. So I would advise people not to do that, but just to smile every day and look at the bright side of life.
Wow. Well, that has been a very good, powerful interview with our own Miss Amaka. And Amma, thank you for being with us. And,
thank you for having me.
And we wish that next year will hold for you and us more time for you to come and impact our community through
that.
Radio Voice of Niger, because it was very difficult to get you here.
I will do that.
Thank you once again.
Thank you for having me.
And have a wonderful Christmas.
You too. And a happy new year to all the listeners.
Thank you. Yeah, okay.